Okay, so we are nearly at the end of this tutorial series and we need to put the finishing touches before the game is done. So one thing we want to add is an in-game menu that will pause the game so that we can press the escape button and then the game will pause and we will get some different options like resume game, restart and click options so we can turn up and down the volume of the music, which we will also add, and we'll also have a quit button there. So yeah, let's add the UI element. We can go to the canvas here and right click and we can add an UI image here. And this image will be named our menu. So this is our menu. So the menu needs a source image. So we can select the source image over here and let's try to write background, and we should take that one called menu background. And we can set the native size. That's a little too big. It's just maybe scale it down, and you just need to scale it down so that it fits like inside of your screen where you want it. So the first thing we want to do is to add some text. So right click on menu and select UI and select text, and this text should write paused like so. And I want to change the font to that color one and want to keep it normal. Font size 50. Line spacing is fine. One is rich text, one is centered in the middle, and horizontal, warp, and let's say, let's try to put best fit, and let's put this one to minimum size 3, maximum size 50 is fine, and I want the color to be white, and no material, and that's it for now. So we can take this, and we can move it all the way up here. And basically I can extend this so that it fills out the whole top here. And let's see here. And then extend it so that it just takes up enough space here, up and down. Basically, okay, if we don't want it to go over the edges, we can also do like so. There we go. So right now it's just white text on gray. I would like to add some more to it, so I can add component and say outline. Because I would like to add an outline, this is fine, the standard is fine, and I would like to add some shadow, and maybe I want to move it a little down, let's say 4, and I want to move it a little, let's say minus 4 here as well, and maybe it's a little too much, I can move it a little in, so you can just adjust this so it fits your needs. Let's try to maximize and see. Yeah, I'm pretty happy with the text here. Okay, so that's the text. The next one we have to do is to add some buttons. So basically, let's try to right click and say add UI image. And let's remove the image here. Don't need that. So this area here is going to be where the buttons are contained in. So basically, we can scale it up so that it fits the area where we would like to put our buttons. So we don't want to go above the area where it was written pause, and we don't want to go below the bottom here. So just scale this one up so it takes out the space where we can put buttons. And then we would like to add some buttons. Let's rename this one to buttons, like so. We need to add some buttons to this menu. So right click on buttons, select UI and select a new button. And we can select the source image here by clicking on it, and then we can write button. And then we have some different buttons here, and I think we just need to take the lightest one. And when we've done that, we can select the text and we can change the font to color one. Or actually we can just go to the text up here. We have the post. If we copy component, then we go to the button text and we can actually click on the text and say paste component values. And as you can see, the button isn't going to be paused, of course, so we can click on it and call resume, and then we have to rename the button to resume as well. There we go. Okay, so right now the button has a weird size, as you can see, and the text is also a little too large, so we need to take the text and make sure that it doesn't go over the borders like so. There we go. And I would also like to add some shadow to the and some outline to the text. And then we can take the shadow and set it to 4 and minus 4. And if it's a little too much, then just change the value. So now let's see it maximized. Now we have a resume button here. Okay. But we would like some more buttons, of course. So let's try to add some more. We need a resume, restart options, and quit. So right click on and say duplicate. Oh, actually, I would like to add something first. I would like to add a layout element so we can override some things later. So we have this layout element here. Let's right click, duplicate, duplicate, and duplicate. So we have this one, we call it restart, resume. Have this one, we call it restart. And then we have our options. And in the end, we have our quit button. And of course, we need to change the names here. We can call this one oh wait, I mixed it up. So this one is not resume, this is our buttons. Sorry about that. So all the other buttons here are not buttons. So let's do like this. Let's try one more time. Okay, from the top we have the resume button under buttons, and we need to duplicate that one 4 times. One is resume, one is restart, one is options, and one is quit. I'm very sorry about the confusion. And of course we need to change the text. So under restart we say restart, and under options we say options, and then we have quit here. Maybe write quit. So there we have them. And right now the buttons are just on top of each other. So we can select the buttons here and add component and take a vertical layout group. And as you can see, they just got thrown to the left. We can simply say child alignment. We can click here and say middle center. Okay. And then we can adjust stuff. Let's see the bottom. We can adjust it so that they are not so close to the bottom if we want to. That's actually all I want to adjust right now. I think it looks fine. Let's see if I maximize. Still look fine? Yeah, it does. So basically we didn't need these layout elements here. But if we wanted to, we could actually adjust them and set a preferred width on them and stuff if we wanted to adjust some things here and override. But anyway, we don't need them right now. Just leave them on for now if we need them later. So that is our option of our pause menu. Right now it's just called menu. Let's call it in game menu. Makes more sense. So we need to call this one at some point. We need to do that in the game manager. So let's find the game manager script. There. So in our game manager we can create a new function called show menu. So let's try to do that. Let's make it public. Function called show in game menu. So this one needs to show the menu. So we can say that we need a reference to the menu first of all. Let's try to find that here. So private game object called pause menu, or let's just call in game menu. So in-game menu, and we're going to serialize so that we can reach it. Set in the inspector, and then we can say that, let's say in-game menu dot set active equals in-game menu dot active self. Okay, so this will set it active if it's inactive, and set it inactive if it's active. It will change it, right? It flip it. So if we save this and simply go to, we have something called handle escape, I think. We have this handle escape function. Let's go to it. And in here, if we press escape, well, then we also need to say show in game menu. Save. There's a lot more things we need to do here, because there's some things we haven't taken into consideration yet. But let's try like this first, game manager, and we have the in-game menu here. Let's make sure that the in-game menu is attached here. And let's try one more time. So if I play the game, I can press the escape button now to show this, right? I can also drop a tower. So basically you can see I'm dropping the towers the same time as I'm showing the menu. And right now it's not pausing. I can play the game, go on the menu, and the monster's still running. So let's fix the pausing first. So the pausing is easy. If I go to the function called showing game menu here, I can simply say, well, if my main menu, in-game menu, that's what it's called, dot active self, if it isn't active, then we say time dot time scale equals 1, and else we do time dot time scale equals 0. So time scale basically makes sure that stuff can move around in the physics engine in Unity. And if I set it to 1, it runs. And if I set it to 0, well, then it doesn't run. So if I set it to 0, the monster should stop moving and they shouldn't be able to do anything. So you can see if it runs, I press escape. Monster pauses, everything pauses, animation pauses and everything. But I can still mouse around and see my tooltips though. And if I click escape again, the monster starts moving. So now I have a pause menu, as you can see. Resume button doesn't work yet. We can also add that. But as you can see, there are lots of different things that escape needs to handle. So if I carry a tower here, I need to press escape and then it should only drop the tower. And then when I press escape again, the pause should run. Because it's annoying if I pause the game every time I want to drop a tower, right? Also, if I have selected this tower and I press escape, I would also like to deselect the tower. So that every time I try to deselect the tower, it doesn't make sense to show the pause menu either. So we need to do those two things as well. So let's do the drop tower first. First of all, we can create a new function called drop tower. And it's going to drop the tower when I press the escape button. So basically we can write a script that makes sure that we don't have a tower in our hand. And to do that, we can simply say click button equals null. So whatever we just clicked is null, so we don't have reference to something we clicked. And we can say hover dot instance dot deactivate. There we go. So that's the drop tower part. Let's try to see if it works. Sorry, we need to run something first, of course, or write something. If we go to handle escape here, then we can change some code around here. We can add some if statements. So if we press escape and if our hover.instance dot is activated and enabled, well, then we say drop tower. I'm not sure that this activate and enable is enough. I think I want to write my own just to make sure it works. If we go to hover, we can make a property here. And it's going to be a bool and it's going to be called visible. Is visible. If I could spell is visible like that. It's going to be a private set. And I think we are enabling it somewhere. We are activating it here. So here we can simply say is visible equals true. And deactivate, we can say is visible equals false. So now we know if it's visible or not. And then we can go back to our game manager. And we can say that instance is visible. So if our hover is visible, then we're going to do this. And we need to do an if statement here. Let's say if our selected tower is null and our hover that instance is visible isn't true, then we say show menu else we drop the tower, okay? So if we haven't selected any tower and we don't have any towers in our hand, then we can show the menu, else we're going to drop the tower. So let's see if I play the game again. I can pick up a tower if I press escape. It still shows, I think I forgot to save actually. Try to save here. Oh, I am deactivating out here. I shouldn't do that either. I should do like this. Yeah. So let's try one more time. And make sure I saved. Play here. We take a tower in our hand. Press escape. And it removes the tower. And I press escape again. And the pause menu is open. That means that I can only... I can only pause when I don't have anything in my hand. But the problem with selecting this... still doesn't work. So now when I have selected a tower, I can't pause the game because if I press escape now, nothing happens. So we also need to handle that. So to do that, we can write an else if statement again. And in here we have to say select tower isn't null. So if our selected tower is null, we simply have to say deselect tower, like so. So now we're deselecting the tower with a function we already created earlier. So if we save this and jump to Unity and play it, we can place the tower, select it, and press escape to deselect it, and press escape again to open the menu. So the last thing I want to do in this video is to fix the resume button, the restart button, and the quit button. And next video we can do the options. So yeah, let's see, we can actually just select the, what is it called, the in-game menu here, and then find the correct button. So we have the options button, which we won't look at now, but we have the quit here, and click the little plus, and then take the game manager here and select function game manager, and there is something called quit game there. So now the quit has that, and then we have our restart. You can click the plus and take the game manager again, put here and game manager, and there should be a restart function there. And I think resume isn't created, so we need to create the resume. Or actually, I think we can click the resume and say plus, and then take the game manager, put it here, and say game manager. And then I think we can find something called show in-game menu. And if we use that one, then it's going to be the same as pressing escape. So if I play now, I can place some towers, I can click escape. I can restart, not restart the game, place a tower, and I can press escape, and I can resume to get back. And then quit is not going to work here in the editor, but it's going to work if you build the game. So options is going to put up a new menu, and we won't do that in this video because it's going to be too long then. Thanks for watching my video. Please remember that InScope Studios is a community-founded page, so please consider clicking the support link on the screen to see how you can support me and get something back in return.